Myself Padmaja, Associate Professor, Department of CEC, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Now, today we are going to discuss about dictionary comprehension in Python. Now, first of all, what is the dictionary comprehension mechanism? So, dictionary comprehension is an elegant and concise way to create dictionaries. Now, if we can create dictionaries by merging the data from two or more iterables, which are either the list or arrays also. So, first of all, before writing the dictionary comprehension mechanism, let us see what is the syntax of it. So, you know that dictionary is a collection of key value pairs. So, whenever you create a dictionary, so it should be written like this. D is equal to key colon value. So, for every key value in iterable. So, the key values pairs can be taken from the iterable and you can construct a new dictionary out of it. Now, let us see some examples how to apply dictionary comprehension mechanism. Now, suppose I want to find out the square of numbers using dictionary comprehension mechanism. So, if I want to find out the numbers from 1 to 10 is there and its squares I want to find out. So, I have to store the numbers as the key and the value as its squares. So, if you observe the output, you can see here that 1 colon 1, if you will observe this, then it means that 1 is nothing but the key and its square is nothing but its value. So, if you will see 981, so 9 is the key and its square is its value. So, the output we want in a dictionary format. So, the numbers are in the range of 1 to 10 and its squares are its values. So, let us see how to write the code. Now, square of dictionary is equal to num colon num into num. So, every number, its square you can write over here. So, you can also write num, you can also write like this, num to the power of 2 also you can write. Both ways it is correct. And for num in the range of 1, 11. So, it is similar to the other comprehension mechanisms which are present in Python. So, here just you have to check that it should be in the key value format. So, it is storing in the key value format and for every number it is computing the square of it and then it is storing. So, this is the output of this program. Now, let us go for the next example where we want to do the price conversion from dollar to pound for the items. Now, first of all, see that there is a dictionary available, so which is a collection of items. So, here milk is one item, its price is given as 1.02. Coffee is another item, its price is given. Bread is item and its value is given. So, here these are the keys. The bread, coffee and milk, these are the keys and the values are given over here. Okay. So, for this values, the values we want to convert from dollar to pound. So, how to convert it? So to convert from dollar to pound, so there is a conversion that we have to multiply by this factor. 0.76. So, for that we will create another dictionary that is called new price. So, for new price, for every item, items are milk, coffee and bread. For every key, colon, value is nothing but the given value, the original value which is present in the old dictionary multiplied by the conversion factor that is dollar to pound which is nothing but 0.76. So, here first value is your 1.02 which will be multiplied. For the milk, the value is 1.02 which will be multiplied by the conversion rate that is 0.76 dollar to pound for every item value in the old price item. So, it will take one item from the old price dictionary and it will convert those values. And again, it will store in the dictionary format. So, you can see here milk and after conversion, this is the price in pounds. Coffee, this is the conversion price and per bread, this is the conversion price. So, this way you can, from the existing dictionary, you are creating a new dictionary using the dictionary comprehension mechanism here. Now, like your set comprehension and your list comprehension, you can also write multiple conditions in the dictionary comprehension. So, for doing that, let us see, there is an original dictionary consisting of the name as the keys and value as their ages. So, this is nothing but the name of the persons are the keys and their ace is the value. So it consists of a collection of or a set of key value pairs as their name and the age of the people or the age of the persons. Now we have to display the name and age of the person where whose age is an even number. So how to do this? For this, so for this we have to write down some condition. So for every key value pair, for every key value pair from the original dictionary dot items, if the value modulus 2 is equal to 0, that means the value is nothing but their age values. So if the ages are, if you will do age modulus 2 is equal to 0, that means the ages are even, then you only store that key value pair whose ages are even. So you can see the output is, for the person RAM, the age is 38, which is even. For the person SAM, the age is 48. So it is only given or stored in the even dictionary. So this way you can write conditions in the dictionary comprehension. Now similarly, if you want to write multiple conditions in the comprehension also, it is permitted, it is allowed. Suppose we want to display the name and age of persons whose age is an odd number and whose age is less than 40. So if two conditions are there, so the person's age should be odd number and it should be less than 40. So if you want to write multiple conditions, you can write like this. So K colon V, key value, for every key value in original dictionary dot items. So if the value is, value modulus 2 is not equal to 0, that means it is checking that the age is odd or not. The second condition is, if the value is less than 40, if the age is less than 40, then based on both the conditions, the particular key value pair will be retrieved from the original dictionary and stored into the even dictionary. So you can see here, one person that matches, that is called Dhyan, and the age is 33. It is odd and also the age is less than 40. So this way, multiple conditions can be written in dictionary comprehension. Similarly, you can also write if-else conditionals in dictionary comprehension. Let us see one example. Suppose the original dictionary contains the name and the age of the persons. So display only the name and age of the persons, or change the age to young or old based on their age. First you check. So if they are greater than 40, then they are old. If they are less than 40, then they are young. So based on this condition, you have to change their age values to young or old. So how to do that? So here original dictionary is given with the name and the age. So this is the name of the persons and these are the age of the persons. Now let us write the comprehension mechanism. So new dictionary, if you want to create, right? New dictionary is equal to key colon, that means therefore every key, check that if the value is greater than 40, then display as old, otherwise display as young. This is called the conditional operator in Python. We are using over here the conditional operator. The conditional operator works like if else condition only. So you have used the conditional operator old if V is greater than 40, else it will print young. So it will check every value. If it is greater than 40, then it will replace with old. If it is less than 40, then it will replace with young. So for every KV from the original dictionary, so it will create a new dictionary. So you can see the output of new dictionary over here. So here RAM is the name as it is, but the age values are replaced by the string young or old. So in this manner, we have created a new dictionary using if-else conditionals. Now, in the similar manner, we can see another example. We can identify the even and odd entries in the dictionary. For example, in the original dictionary, it is a collection of key value pairs over here. So A is equal to 1, B is 2, C is 3, D is 4, and so on. So out of this, we have to segregate the even and odd. If it is even, then you have to display as even, the string as even. And if it is odd, then you have to display the string as odd. So how to do that? Now, you observe the output first. So A is containing 1, so which is an odd number. So you have to display as odd. B is 2, which is an even number. So display it as even. C is 3, so display it as odd, and so on. Now let us see how to write it. So K colon even. You display it as even if V modulus, if that value modulus 2 is equal to 0, that means it is even condition. We are checking. If it is even, then display it as even. Else display it as odd. So for every key value pair in D dot items, that means from the dictionary you take each key value pair, and that value part you check it using the conditions. If it is satisfies, then you store it as a key value pair into another dictionary using this comprehension mechanism. So this is the way we have segregated the odd evens, and we have replaced with the odd even as the string values in the output. Now, dictionary comprehension can also be used to map the values from different containers. So how to map the different values from two different containers using zip method, let us see one example. Now, for example, here roll number is a list. Roll number is a list over here. And the names are another list. This is list of integers or list of roll numbers, let us say. And this is list of names. So here two containers or two lists are given. Using zip method, we have to combine the values from both the containers, and we have to store it in the form of a dictionary. Let us see. So new dictionary is equal to I colon J, that is key value pair, I colon J format we want. For every IJ, for every key value, I is the key and J is the value over here. For every key value pair, use zip method. So what to do? Take the roll number, one value from the list of roll numbers and one value from the list of names, and you zip it and you combine it. So it will take one value from each container and it will combine. So you can see here 122 is combined with Alok, your 233 is combined with Bobby, 353 is combined with Mukund, and 456 is combined with your Kumud and Mukund. So you can see here the output is, using this zip method, we have taken pair of values from different containers and we have combined them, and so that it looks like a key value pair, and we have stored it into a dictionary. So this is the way dictionary comprehension mechanism is used. So thank you so much. So today we have discussed about how to use dictionary comprehension mechanism in Python. Thanks.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.